to my channel, and today we're doing another Ruvim Reviews. This is part three, and we're reviewing things from Five Below.
Yeah, a whole lot of stuff from Five Below. If you guys are not familiar with Five Below, it's almost like a dollar store, except instead of things being a dollar, everything, almost everything, is like $5 or less.
Yeah, but there's also dollar products.
That is true.
Five Below. But before we get started, remember to smash that like button and press that subscribe button and press that notification bell to get notified every time I post a new video. Let's get on with it. So here's the products in the bag. Got a lot. Well, not a lot, but five things that we wanted to review the most.
All right. So,
first product.
Here we go.
Squishy thing first.
All right, so first up, we've got this squishy thing.
It's like a stress ball.
It says, it actually calls it a mesh ball.
Yeah.
Or no, a mesh squeeze ball.
I've always was weirded out by these things. Like.
Yeah, it does look rather strange. I wonder if we cut the mesh, how it would kind of react. Cool.
What do you think of it?
Let me see.
This product was a dollar, by the way, so if you're on a budget, I think it's worth it. Yeah, but what would you give it?
What exactly are we rating it on?
I mean, if it's like worth it or not.
Oh, just worth it or not? Okay, for a dollar, yeah, why not? Yeah.
Yeah, if you're on a budget, I think it's worth it. I would give it like a 3 out of 5.
I mean, it's not. It smells. Here, smell it real quick.
Smells like weird soap.
To me, it smells like Silly Putty or something like that. Like some kind of Play-Doh or something. But I would give it like a. Or as far as like value for the price, on a scale of 1 to 10. I'd give it like a 7, because I mean I think it's worth a dollar.
Yeah, I'd give it like a 8 or a 7 if we were gonna. Yeah, I think it's worth it.
No, I don't know how long. Here, do you want to check it
out? I don't know how long these last, but I don't.
Right.
I don't think they last very long, but it's pretty cool for a dollar, especially.
Yeah, we can't necessarily recommend these for stress because they may break within a few. Obviously, they don't break within a few uses because we've been playing with it.
Yeah.
But they may break after, 50 uses. So I can't necessarily recommend them for stress, but
they look cool.
Give it a try. See what happens. they're only a dollar.
Yeah.
Next up is this treasure alien, I guess is what
treasure alien egg or whatever thing. Yeah. I think it was also a dollar, so.
I think this one was a little bit more. This one was actually $5.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah. So
let's see if it's worth it or not.
Right. Let's just give it a go, I guess. Sounds weird.
Yeah. It does sound weird.
All right. So first of all, so this just, that just breaks open. Well, I'll bet it comes out this end.
Well, it just popped open.
Oh, it's got snot all over it. Is this the crystal thing that we were supposed to get?
Apparently.
Did we get the magic crystal?
Oh,
I got the magic
crystal. We lost it! I don't think it's worth $5.
So you squeeze the side, and then... Oh my gosh, that is sick.
What do you say? Is it worth $5?
Oh, man. Let me figure out if I can even get it from the alien first. It's... Oh, dude. You want to feel it?
It feels gross. Ew.
Yeah, it's like snot mixed with rubber. It's... Ew. I'm trying to get it consolidated, but it doesn't want to. Okay, so I would like to comment that it's very difficult to get the snot back in it.
Yeah, and it's very gross. Mm-hmm. I say it's not worth it. For $5.
I mean, if you're into totally gross, disgusting stuff, then maybe. But it was a pain in the butt to try and get this thing's snot back in the alien. So
I say I'll give it a 3 out of 10.
I'll give it like a 5 out of 10.
Next product.
Yeah. Well, a little bit on that last one that we just did. One note that should be obvious, but just in case it isn't already, I do not recommend that for anybody under the age of probably 8.
Yeah.
Because that is one of the messiest toys ever.
And even if they are 8, even if the kids are 8, they would probably need parent supervision on that.
I would agree with that. All right, next up, we're going to check out these. They're sort of like, they're like discount AirPods.
Yeah.
So
they cost $5 at Five Below.
I think these ones were 8.
Well, 8. Which kind of makes them seem like they're lying, because it's supposed to be $5.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah. Yeah, they do have a few items at Five Below that are more. I think the highest thing that you can get there is like $10. Here, I'm going to actually.
Woo! Or turns them on. I don't know. This is our first time trying them.
Interesting. All right, so we got this little cord. To charge them, I guess. Oh, here you go. Charger for the back of the.
Then you just plug it into a standard.
Yeah. These are fit for an Android, not an iPhone. Just letting you guys know. Which, aren't there regular AirPods? Isn't that Apple?
Yes. So you could tell that they're a knockoff.
Okay, it says charging case included, hands-free, I should hope so. auto pairing, micro cable included, superior sound. Superior sound from it.
Well, I hope so. Probably not, though, because they were a knockoff. Like $8.
Okay. I don't know why I have this plugged in, it's not even charging. okay, let's crack this open.
Wait, we have to press the button to pair it right.
Yeah, we gotta turn them on first, though. Or are they already on?
I think they're on.
I think they are, yeah.
They're flashing. At least one of them is. But they don't feel comfortable in your ears.
They don't?
That's for sure.
Okay, so let's keep track of it. So you're gonna use that one? Do you mind if I use this other one?
Yeah.
Okay. This is left, okay. They're rather large.
Bulky.
Yeah.
So.
A few points off for that. Okay.
At least one.
What do you want to do? You want to listen to some music?
Yeah.
All right. These might be dead, though, so that may be an issue. Actually, do you mind if I hold it while... Can I pick a song that is not copyrighted to put it up to there so that they can hear it?
Sure.
Or, okay. What is a song that's not copyrighted?
I have no idea.
Non-copyrighted music. Okay, here's some. Hopefully this actually is not copyrighted. We'll see if you guys can hear this. Where's the speaker at?
They're near the charger
port. Near the charger?
I hope you can hear it, because
Ruvim's over there going deaf. So they're down here?
Yeah.
Here, I'm going to turn up even louder. Do you want to take that one out just so it doesn't kill you?
Yeah. I mean, I can hear it out of my ears, so.
Sorry. I think I just blocked the camera there.
I can hear it out of my ears, so I wouldn't say the quality is that good, like the sound quality as they claim it to be.
I thought the sound quality was actually not bad. Mm. Did you not care for it?
I mean, I thought it was going to be a little louder, but
okay. I actually am. I mean, for what it is, for $8 AirPods,
I think if you're on a budget, it's worth it.
Yeah. If they actually stay in your ear.
Yeah.
Bouncing around. They don't feel like they're going to come out at any second. They feel fairly... I'm just going to do a dance over here. Sorry, y'all had to see that. They don't feel like they're just about to pop out of your ear. So, I mean, that's a plus.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, so what would you give it on a scale of 1 to 10?
I'd give it a 6 or a 7.
Okay. I'd give it a 7 or an 8. Honestly, I was pretty impressed by the sound quality of them.
Next product.
All right, so we've got this.
Air pump rocket.
Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly what it says right here. Blasts over 100 feet.
Let's hope we can find it afterwards.
So I wouldn't recommend doing this in a forest. Probably not a good idea.
Oh, that's the air pump. Where's the rocket? Oh, that's it.
Yeah.
I thought it would be bigger, like...
Me too. I'm a little underwhelmed with the size of the rocket.
Yeah. So. Looks more like an arrow than a rocket that you could shoot with a bow and arrow.
It actually looks really easy. It's like, extremely self-explanatory. These are legs that you put on here to stand it up. I guess you probably just...
Here, I can hold it for you.
Thanks, bro. Just slide those on. Oh, you can angle this. That's cool. That's a little bit loose. Might be an issue.
Well, it doesn't feel like there's air coming out of it, but maybe I'm just not pressing hard enough.
So it looks like you just set it up like that, put the rocket on, and kaboom.
Yeah, let's go test it outside, because I don't want to test it in here. First test. Up for the rocket. Okay, let's get to it. 3, 2, 1.
So,
that was lame.
That only went up about 6 feet in the air.
Yeah.
Let's give it another try.
3, 2, 1. Oh, okay, it's up there. Oh, I hope I got that in camera a little bit. That actually went pretty high, huh?
Yeah.
Wasn't too bad, right?
I would just say it's 100 feet.
Yeah, that probably went up, I don't know, maybe like 50 or 60 feet.
All right, so this time I'm gonna like stomp on it about as hard as I can. See if we can get it to go up actually even close to 100 feet. We'll see. Okay, whenever you're ready.
3, 2, 1. It went up definitely high.
Yeah. I think over 100 feet is probably a
little
statement.
Overstatement.
Yeah.
So what would you give it overall, Charles?
Overall, I mean, it did work. Setup was extremely simple.
Yeah.
There was almost no setup involved. It's very, very easy to use.
I don't even know why they give instructions with this.
Right. It's as much as I use instructions, I think it didn't need them. So I would give it, those are the positives. The negatives, or it didn't shoot as high as it said it would.
Yeah, that's one downside.
Because it said it shoots over 100 feet. About the highest we could get it to shoot was like 60 or 70 feet.
Yeah.
I'd give it like maybe a 6 out of 10.
I'd give it a 6 or 7 out of 10.
Okay. So.
Yeah. But I say it's worth it for... Like how much it costs.
Yeah, was this one of the ones that was actually $5? The rocket. Yes, this was only $5. So yeah, I mean,
you could have some fun with it.
Yeah, not a bad little toy for what it is. What's really cool, you can angle it and stuff. So if you want to like shoot it at people, that's kind of fun. And it's very.
But we don't recommend that. don't want anybody to get injured. So
yeah. Disclaimer.
Yeah, disclaimer about that.
All right, next up. It's a ball.
The ball.
How much was this? This one was $4. Which honestly, you might be able to get it for cheaper somewhere else. It seems like a fairly cheap item, but...
Yeah, I like the colors.
Yeah, it does have some cool colors to it, though.
Let's see if it bounces.
All right, probably not on the table. I'll probably miss it with the camera. Where should we do this? You want to take this outside?
We were just outside. Maybe like right in the living room.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll just take you over there. Come on. Can I bounce it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well.
There you go.
Let's see. It's pretty bouncy. Pretty bouncy. I would say.
Yeah. Not really a whole lot to review with it. Oh, there you go.
It's a lot of fun though.
Utah, what would you give it on a scale of 1 to 10?
I say I like the colors, so, and plus it's fun to play with.
It is fun.
And pretty bouncy, so I'd give it like a 6 out of 10.
Okay. Yeah, I'd say I'd give it 6 or 7 out of 10. I mean, it does what it's supposed to. There's nothing special.
Yeah. I bet you could get it for cheaper, like at the dollar store or something.
That's what I'm thinking too. I'm thinking $4 is a little bit pricey for it.
Yeah.
I'm thinking
that should get it a point knockoff. So I'd give it like a 5 out of 10.
Okay. I'm going to still stick with 6 out of 10 because I think if it was cheaper, I'd give it like a 7 out of 10.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's interesting looking.
Yeah. Yeah. Guys, this is the end of the video. And remember, if you liked it, leave a like. And a comment. Let us know what you would get at Five Below that you saw in this video down in the comments.
Also, if there's anything, any other products or stores you would like us to review, let us know in the comments. Let us know what you guys want to see.
Yeah. Oh, and I came out with merch that you should really check out. I'll leave a link down in the description.
Yeah.
But anyways, remember to spread positivity, and I will see you next time. Bye.